Washington, Kentucky, and he's our Golf Channel Academy Coach of the Week. He works with junior golfers, high-level golfers, beginners. Larry, good morning. How are you?
Doing great.
It's
doing
great to visit with you. There are so many people that want to get better. There are juniors who want to get a college scholarship. Yeah. There are folks at home this morning that want to break 100, break 90.
Sure.
Folks in Studio A who want to break 80. That's me. Get us there. How do we get there, Larry?
The formula we use is 20 hours a week, 50 weeks a year. That's 1,000 hours a year. If we can get a student to limit the distractions, keep it really on course.
Wow.
7,500 hours usually is where those guys you've seen on television, that's where they're at.
You can't fake it.
Can't fake it.
Okay.
That's right. No way.
So how do you break down 7,500 hours to reach the next level? How do you decide, okay, this is going to be spent on putting, this will be spent on chipping, this will be spent the mental aspect of the game?
Yeah, it's totally player dependent. You know, certain players, you know, one of the things that we really believe in is everyone has a skill set. So everyone's good at something.
Sure.
We don't get too caught up in what a player can't do.
Okay.
It's not to worry about all the things that they're not good at. That time will take care of that. Let's really just work on what their strengths are.
Okay.
And go with that. Go run with the strengths, see what happens, get down the road. Somewhere around 3,000 hours, 7,500 hours, we have a very good feel for where that player is.
Okay. You have four tenants. You also have a rope here. It's an Olympic year. I wonder if this is like for the high hurdles, but probably not.
I think we're do the, you know.
Go to the limbo. We can do the limbo on a Tuesday. What's this rope for? What are we doing here?
Here's what we do, and this is for the players at home.
Okay.
You can take these alignment sticks, stick them in the ground.
Yep.
Okay. And what I do is, and, you know, you can use this for driver, wedge, irons, doesn't matter. So I've got a 7-iron today.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to measure from my sternum. I'm going to kind of, like a laser beam's coming out of my sternum, point at the golf ball there. Now, once I'm set up there, I have good body orientation to something. I can see how I'm going to see the target line. I can kind of see everything fits. It helps me with a lot of different things. I like drills that will give me multiple things to work on at the same time.
Interesting.
So with this drill, I can kind of work on mainly hand path, how it's going to work, how the hands are going to work there. So the club's going back. I'm loading up.
Mm-hmm.
You can feel how the club's going to come down, missing the rope. And you'll see my hands actually right there pointed to the right. That's what most good ball strikers do. The club kind of gets a little behind them there.
Yeah.
Club's coming down. Now the hands start to turn around. They start to make the turn left. Left shoulder's going up, back, and around. And when that happens, they miss the rope on the exit.
How about that?
So now we've stopped the player from any throwing the club that way.
Yeah.
We stopped the player from being able to come under and release early.
Interesting.
Now, that rope's on there very loose. We don't have
a
rope burn. So, you know, it's really good to have the player make some swings and miss the rope.
So this is actual feedback that will give the folks at home really immediate, you know, information on whether they're doing the golf swing correctly or incorrectly.
Sure. Absolutely.
Someone who swung the golf club correctly, who still does, is Jack Nicklaus. This week we celebrate the Memorial Tournament. You look at the video of Jack, you see his feet moving around a little bit. I mean, he's swinging hard, he's swinging for the fences, but look at his feet, he's like Bubba Watson, he's dancing around a little bit. To me, is that a little counterintuitive, or do you like that footwork, Larry?
Love it.
You don't like it, you love it.
Love it.
Why do you love it?
You know, a few things, you know, with Jack's swing there, and for whatever reason, a few years ago, we got away from allowing the hips to kind of turn, allowing the, you know, some freedom down there, some things like that. Started talking about words like restriction and things like that.
Yes.
They just don't work for most players.
Okay.
Okay. And so with Jack, a drill that I have for my players to get them to use the ground properly, we're going to talk about load, store, and explode.
Okay.
Okay. So we're going to have the players go back and load. You can lift the left heel a little bit.
You're okay with that.
Yeah. Let that hip retract.
Yeah.
This knee kind of straighten a little bit. They're pushing down the right heel, and now the player is going to store. They're going to come down. You see, I reset the heel just like Nicklaus did. Reset, and then I want to push off the ground, get the left shoulder moving up, back, and around, and get the explosion through the shot.
I love that.
We're loading down, moving into the left leg, using the ground, going through the shot.
The ground is your friend.
Absolutely.
Use it. Rory McIlroy uses it.
Absolutely.
Jack Nicklaus uses it.
Yeah.
And Larry Ward uses it.
That's right.
Excellent, folks. Tomorrow, he's going to be back to work on your short game. And yes, he talked about the four tenets to improvement. Go to GolfChannelAcademy.com, Facebook, and Twitter pages to learn the other three. It includes this, the mental aspect of the game. Larry, great job. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
You're going to come back?
Tomorrow.
Excellent. Larry Ward will be back with you tomorrow. Coming up next, Pine.